हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 15 कॉल्ड बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड कंजर्वेशन। सो यू हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न्ड अबाउट टू चैप्टर्स इन दिस यूनिट ऑफ इकोलॉजी। द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वाज व्हाट ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड पॉपुलेशन, द सेकेंड वॉज इकोसिस्टम, एंड इन दिस चैप्टर अबाउट बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड कंजर्वेशन, लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स एट डिफरेंट लेवल्स ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। एंड वी ऑल्सो ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द डाइवर्सिटी ऑफ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैज़ बीन स्प्रेड थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड और थ्रू आउट द ग्लोब, राइट? सो एंड ऑल्सो हाउ द बायोडाइवर्सिटी इज इन थ्रेट टूडे, एंड ऑल्सो हाउ वी कैन कंजर्व, हाउ वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट इट, वाई टू प्रोटेक्ट इट, राइट? सो वॉट इज द बेनिफिट ऑफ प्रोटेक्टिंग द बायोडाइवर्सिटी, हाउ इट विल बी हेल्पिंग अस टू सर्वाइव ऑन दिस अर्थ, राइट? वी विल ट्राई टू मेक एन अटेम्प्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट्स इन दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर कॉल्ड बायोडाइवर्सिटी एंड कंजर्वेशन, राइट? सी वॉट कम्स टू योर माइंड वेन वी यूज द वर्ड बायोडाइवर्सिटी। सी इफ एनी, इमेजिन इफ एनी एलियन लैंड्स ऑन द अर्थ, if any alien lands on the earth by mistake, accidentally, then he or she, the alien, will be mesmerized to look at the beauty of the earth and to look at the diversity of life forms on the earth. Yes or no? There are so many life forms, and even today we are not able to discover each and every species of plant or each and every species of insect or each and every species of animal present on the earth. So much advancement in technology, so much growth of the mental abilities of human beings, but still, even today, human beings have not been able to study the entire life forms, entire biodiversity of the earth. Forget about different plants. We have not yet done with planet Earth, right? Right. So now let us see the diversity of life forms on the earth. See, just to take an account of how diversified the earth is, like around 20,000 species of ants, around 3 lakh species of beetles. These are called as beetles, different types of beetles, right? And also around 28,000 species of fishes, right? And also 20,000 species of orchids. Beetles, these are the different species of fishes, around 20,000 species are there. These are the orchids, right? And why? By looking at so much diversity of life forms, the question arises, why should be so much diversity on this earth, and how this diversity has been formed? Why so much diversification? How did it happen? How is biodiversity beneficial to the biosphere? Not to human beings, not to any other organism, not to any individual species. How is this biodiversity beneficial to biosphere? So these are the basic questions that may arise when we look at this mesmerizing and beautiful diversity of the earth. Well, in order to answer these questions, we need to study and understand the various aspects of this chapter called biodiversity and conservation. Anyway, let me make an attempt to give the immediate response to these questions. Why so much biodiversification? See, in the course of evolution, of course, you are going to study in a separate chapter about evolution. In the course of evolution, what has happened is one type of living organism, as it was exposed to different types of environmental conditions. So you know that survival of the fittest theory given by Darwin, right? So here what the theory says, the organisms must be able to adapt or able to adjust to the external environmental conditions. If not, the organism cannot survive on the particular habitat. ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೋ ಒಂದು ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟೆಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ತಕ್ಕಾಗಿರುವಂತಹ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರೆ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹೀಗೆ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಗಳಿಗೆ ಅಡ್ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಹೋಲ್ ದೇ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್, ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿಕಲ್, ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಫಿಸಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನಾಟಮಿಕಲ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಲೆಡ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಪೀಶಿಯೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೀಶೀಸ್. or origin of different forms of species. That is why the diversification is there. So basically, diversification is there because of the different types of habitats provided by the earth to different set of living organisms. This can be a convincing answer. How did it happen? Well, there are different theories to explain how the diversity of life forms has taken place. Right? So you are going to study about different theories. One theory helate, maybe from one point of origin, the organisms, they started traveling towards different types of habitats, and alli bere bere habitat galalli iruvantaha environmental conditions galige hondukollikke adaptation galanna maadkontu hagagi bere bere species bantu anta heli. This is one theory. The another theory says what? Different life forms were already present in different regions of the earth, and they started moving towards one common point, one common land piece. Aga, they all started gathering at one point and they all started developing similar characteristics, and that is how a group of organisms developed something called as a group of species. Idu innond theory. Like this, there are many theories which give us an account about how did this diversification happen. Then one more very important question here: how is biodiversity is beneficial to the biosphere? See, any living organism present on the earth has to undergo one or the other type of interaction. This we have already understood in the first chapter of the ecology unit in the organisms and population. See, what have you learnt about the population interactions? Different types of interaction bagge kalthidiri alwa, yavudella commensalism irbodu, amensalism irbodu, mutualism irbodu, right? Different types of interaction we have learnt, and we have also understood without these type of interactions, without any of these type of interaction, yavudo ondu interaction alli participate madlilla anta helidre, it becomes very difficult for any organism or any species to survive on this earth. That means it is for sure that no organism can survive on this earth completely independently. It has to be interdependent on each others, right? So that is why biodiversity alli, how that means how rich is the biodiversity, that much stable will be the biosphere. ಎಷ್ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಹೌ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನ್, ಹೌ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಫೈಡ್ ದ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ, ಅಷ್ಟು ಇಂಟರ್ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆನ್ಸಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಸ್ಟೆಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಎಕೋಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಅಲ್ವಾ. ಎನಿವೇ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್, ರೈಟ್? ದೆನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಯೋಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಸಿ, ಬಯೋಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ, ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ವಾಲ್ಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೋಸನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1985. ಎನಿವೇ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ನೀಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ವರಿಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್. ಮೇ ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಟಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್. ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಅನ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸಿ ಟಿ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್, ವೆರಿ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್, even though the biodiversity was coined in the year 1985 by Walter and Rosen, it was later popularized by Edward Wilson, Edward O. Wilson, in the year 1988 when he wrote a book by the name Biodiversity. The title of the book was Biodiversity, right? And he also compiled the concept of biodiversity. That means he considers, he not only talks about the species level of biodiversity, species level of biodiversity matra alla alli, see, he also looks into different levels of biological organizations, and he summarized the total different levels of organizations biodiversity, and he in a broader way used the word biodiversity. That means he explained the combined diversity of all the levels of biological organizations. Biodiversity refers to biological diversity. So biodiversity is a like a short form of biological diversity. So it is nothing but a variety of living organisms at different regions of the earth at different levels of biological organizations, right? So when we talk about biodiversity, when we talk about the diversity of life forms on the earth, so it does not only take into account the wild forms. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ವೈಲ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಮಾತ್ರ ಅಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ಸಾಕಿರುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಡಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅಕೌಂಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇರ್ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆದರ್ ದ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೇರ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಡೊಮೆಸ್ಟಿಕ್, ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಅಟೋಟ್ರೋಫ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹೆಟೆರೋಟ್ರೋಫ್ಸ್, ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್, ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೋ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಟಿಕ್ ಆರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾರಿಯೋಟಿಕ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಇರ್ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ದ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಅಕೌಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಬಯೋಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಆರ್ಗಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ನೋನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅನ್ನೋನ್. It is not only known organisms, there are so many living organisms, there are so many species of plants and animals yet to be discovered. They come under this category unknown. So known and unknown, wild and domesticated, different forms, maybe the smallest of microorganisms, maybe the biggest of all the organisms. So yellavanna consider madidaga, so that will be taking into account under the word biodiversity. So how can we arrive at the definition of biodiversity? So this is the definition: the immense diversity of or heterogeneity in the biosphere at all the levels of biological organizations, ranging from macromolecular level to the within the cells to biomes. See, idana nanu already nimge helidene. This we have already considered in the chapter of organisms and population. Macromolecule level in the biome level varege alli different levels of biological organizations irutte anta helidene. The diversity at all these different biological organizations will be called as biodiversity. So this can be an important one mark question for you. This is the definition of biodiversity: the immense diversity or heterogeneity in the biosphere at all the levels of biological organizations, ranging from macromolecules within the cells up to the biome. I hope you understood, right? Moving forward, see, diversity at different levels of biological organization. I just mentioned in the previous slide here, illi nan just mention madidde different levels of biological organization anta helidre. So then see, if you start from the level of macromolecules, macromolecules, then cellular level, then tissue level, then organ level, then organismic level, then population level, then community level, then ecosystem level, then biome level. But we will not study the diversity at these different levels of organization. Of course, what levels we are going to study will be corresponding with these different levels of biological organizations. And what are those different levels of biological organizations at which we study the biodiversity are: one is genetic biodiversity, then species biodiversity, and ecological or ecosystem or habitat biodiversity. So ee mooru heading under nalli naavu we are going to study the different levels of biodiversity. Genetic biodiversity anta helidre, so it is talking about the diversity within the cell alva. Macromolecular level, so it is mainly talking with respect to DNA and DNA and RNA, nucleic acid jotege maatadta idevi. And species level biodiversity, this is individual, we are talking about individual species here. Ecological andre habitat level nalli different habitats, they provide different living place for different types of living organisms. Habitat bagge maatadtirbekadre, so the biome or the biota or the living organisms corresponding with that habitat also will be taken into consideration here, right? So going forward, for the genetic biodiversity, hagadre genetic biodiversity andre inu, it refers to the variability within the species. If you consider any species, like for example human beings, homo sapiens one species ana consider madidre, in the homo sapiens itself, if you visit different countries or different continents of the world, if you go to Africa, you will see people very tall and darker. If you come to India, we are brown people with moderate height. If you go to Australia, taller people with a white skin or pinkish colored skin. If you go to China, yellow skin people, dwarf height. Andre homo sapiens one species agidru kuda, will we not find different types of variety here? So why this variety comes, why this difference comes in the appearance morphologically, it is mainly because of the genes that they carry. And how the genes are there in those people, why African people are black, why Indian people are brown, it always depends upon the what biological setup or environmental conditions in which any organisms live. Yes or no? So that is how it is. It refers to the variability within a species as determined by the genetic constitution, genetic makeup. Okay, so whatever the genome of the organism is there depends upon that. It may be a variation of genes within the subspecies. Andre subspecies anta helidre hege varieties anta karitivi. If you visit a market in the mango season, new ondu fruit shop ig hodre, definitely you will come across at least some 3 to 4 different varieties of mangoes. Yes or no?
ಮ್ಯಾಂಗೋ ಯಾವುದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮ್ಯಾಂಜಿಫರಾ ಇಂಡಿಕಾ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೇಮ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಬಟ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್. ಒಂದು ಮಲ್ಲಿಕಾ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬಾದಾಮ್ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅಲ್ಫೋನ್ಸೋ ಅಂತ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ವೆರೈಟೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸಿ ದ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್, ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಲರ್, ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫರೆನ್ಸಸ್ ವಿತ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಮೆನಿ ಮಾರ್ಫಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಫಿಸಿಯಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ ಬಯೋಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. Yes or no? That means, why these differences are there? Mainly because of the genes that they inherit. Correct, no? So, and all this genetic biodiversity, the basis of all this is sexual reproduction. Yes or no? See, if there is no sexual reproduction, then how can the genes be mixed? If the genes are not mixing with each other, if the genes of two different individuals are not mixing with each other, the next progeny will not have any difference. You have already learned in the sexual reproduction in the flowering plants, the significance of sexual reproduction. The significance of genetic biodiversity is nothing but sexual reproduction. It will bring about the diversity at the level of genes. Right? Let us look at some examples here. See, you are seeing the different set of people here. Right? So, you can look at the differences with respect to their height, the differences with respect to their color of the skin, differences with respect to their the hair, type of hair that they possess, maybe the differences with respect to the color of the eyeball. All these are the differences mainly based on what? The genetic differences. Look at the other picture here. These are the different breeds of cows present in India. Only in India we have got so many different breeds of cow. Sindhi, Sahiwal, Tharparkar, right? Haryana, Ongole, these are different breeds. Morphologically, physiologically, they are different, right? So one cow may be very strong, the other may yield good amount of milk, the other may be meant for what? Some other purpose, right? Like this. Different breeds have got different characteristic features here, and this is what is referred to as morphological level of genetic diversity. The genetic diversity at morphological level in humans and in cows. Let us consider one more example in plants. See, look at this. These are all the different varieties of mangoes. ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಹೆಸರು ಬರೆದಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಬಂಗನ್ಪಲ್ಲಿ, ರೈಟ್? ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮಲ್ಗೋವಾ, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಮದ್ದರಸಂ, ಆಮ್ಲೆಟ್, ಕೇಸರ್, ಕುದಾದತ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸಿಂಧೂರ್, ಮಲ್ಲಿಕಾ, ದಶೇರಿ, ರುಮಾನಿ, ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ವೈ ದ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗಿವನ್? ಸೊ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಕಲರ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್. ಡಿಪೆಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅಪಾನ್ ವೇರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಗ್ರೋಯಿಂಗ್, ಸೊ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಅಡಾಪ್ಟ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೀಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಚರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಹೆರಿಟೆಡ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕಲಿ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೆಫರ್ಡ್ ಟು ಆಸ್ ಜೆನೆಟಿಕ್ ಡೈವರ್ಸಿಟಿ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ in the next class we are going to study about the other two types of diversities, that is the species diversity and habitat diversity.